you guys have had a couple exhibitions and now one game. Are you ready to step up to a major opponent?
Ask me that after the game. I don't know. I think we're getting better, but we got to take better care of the ball. I mean, it comes down to you can't turn it over that many times and be good people.
So what's Pitt do well when you scout them?
Shoot the ball. Mm-hmm. They do a great job of spreading you because they have multiple guys that can make shots.
Members of the media, please use the raise hand feature for a question. Greg, you have another one. Your hand's still raised.
Yeah, I'll keep going. The scout in today's world for these early season games, when there's so many new faces, is that more difficult? How do you do this when you may not have seen the guys play together at Pitt before?
It's obviously more difficult because you don't have as many things to look at. But they played an exhibition game, you know, like we did. And then we exchanged, I think we exchanged exhibition game video. So they've seen us, we've seen them.
Oh, no hands are currently raised. Please use the raise hand feature for a question. We'll go to John and Tony. John, you're muted.
Yeah. Hey, missed part of it, but I guess last year's game is really meaningless since you got two new teams. You got what, two players that played in last year's game that are going to be back, and I think they have three if Hudley plays, right? So really meaningless.
Yeah, I mean they've done a really good job of solidifying their roster. They've brought in a bunch of guys who can make shots, and went to more of a spread kind of deal. And I mean we're a whole lot different. I mean the last few times we played, we were pressing, you know, from start to finish, and we're a whole lot different than what we were then, and they're a whole lot different than the last time we played them.
Hey, Hugs, I'm looking here. 41 threes they took in that game, and Henson, 6'7" wing, took 12 of them. What to see? What's some of the challenges you have to deal with guarding him?
6'7", 255 pounds, and he can really, really shoot the ball. He really shoots the ball. He's got a great touch. He's got a quick release. He's really good, and he's really good in transition. And he's good enough that if you try to crowd him or you kind of go at him a little bit off balance, he's going to drive it by you. And he's big and strong enough to finish inside. So he causes a lot of problems.
And one other one here, Federico, I know he's a guy you're familiar with a little bit recruiting wise. What does he offer? And I guess he's a pretty good alternative to Hudley if Hudley can't play.
Well, Hughley's going to play.
Yeah.
And
I did. He's reports that they got him doing on contact. Yeah. Man. Yeah.
I also know everybody in Cleveland too. So he's going to play, John.
Well, I did read that he was doing non-contact stuff this week. So I guess plan on him, right?
I tell you what, he's a load on a block.
Mm-hmm.
He's really good on the block. He's different than Federico. Federico is kind of one of those, he's really mobile, really can run. Shot blocker, he's not going to be able to score it the way Hughley scores it, but it's in terms of what he does defensively for him and keeps balls alive, He's been really good for him.
Coach, our next question comes from Jerry DePaula.
Thank you very much, Coach Huggins, for your time today. My question is more of a big picture thing rather than a Pitt, West Virginia thing. What would 1,000 victories mean to you, and how long do you think you want to keep coaching?
It'd mean I'm older. I don't know. You know, I don't want to overstay my time. But I mean, I feel good about it now. I think I'm still got the energy to do it. I think I can still relate to the guys. So I'm enjoying this year. I think, you know, I enjoy this team. But I'm not gonna, you know, I don't, the answer is I don't know, but I'm not going to overstay my welcome.
Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Bob Hertzel.
Bob, I assume you would prefer to play Pitt with a team that has been through it before, especially up there a couple of times, but my look at your team in their first game seems to say that they have the right attitude to go up, the right kind of attitude to go up there and face what they're going to face there.
Well, you know, Bob, you're right on all counts. I would rather have played there before, some guys that played there before. But we have guys that have played, we've got guys that have played in some really hard places too. You know, we've got guys that played in the SEC. We have guys that played in a lot of big time leagues at big time places. Wasn't Pitt, but it was big time atmospheres. So I think those guys will, you know, we bring Joe off the bench, who's played in virtually every big arena in the Big Ten. So they've been there before. Those guys have been there before. I don't think playing at Pitt is any going to be any different for them than playing in the Big Ten.
How important is attitude when you're playing against Pitt as compared to, say, maybe the last game they played or whatever?
Well, I don't think they understand the rivalry. You know, we don't have guys who grew up watching the rivalry or hearing about the rivalry. They don't really know anything about it. We haven't talked about it at all. We haven't spent 5 seconds talking about it.
Thank you.
Next question comes from Justin Jackson.
Hey, Coach, how you doing?
Good, Justin.
Hey, kind of going off of what you were just talking about, not having guys familiar with the rivalry. You know, that's obviously much different, you know, than when, you know, both schools are back in the Big East and guys, you know, played against each other in summer leagues and you recruited against Pitt for Big East guys. So now that things are different, how much does that, you know, make, I mean, it doesn't make your job any different to prepare for them, but how much does that just, you know, kind of make this whole situation different?
I don't know, Justin. You know, you could have said the same thing of when I played here and we played Pitt, it was a whole lot different than playing Pitt in the Big East.
Sure.
I mean, when I played here, it was a big time rivalry. I mean, that's when they were throwing carp on the floor and, you know, fights in the stands.
Yeah.
I mean, it was big time. And you know, it's the Big East was a great rivalry, you know, and, well, we played them twice during the year and then played them in a tournament, played them in a conference tournament. So we played them three times in 1 year. And but Jamie's gone, you know, Jamie's gone. It's a different era for them. It's a different style of play. Their tickets are a lot more expensive. So, I mean, it's an entirely different ball game.
And from what I've kind of researched, like, so you guys go up to Pitt this year, they come back to the Coliseum next year, and is that the end of the deal as it currently stands?
As it currently stands, yeah.
Okay.
That was done with the ADs.
Right.
That was Shane and the Pitt AD.
Do certain things, in your opinion, do certain things have to be met in order to keep this going, to sign an extension?
It's above my pay grade.
Okay.
That's the athletic directors. The athletic directors do that. I think in 99% of the cases, the coaches do it. But in that instance, because of the familiarity, because of the how close the two schools are, and because of the rivalry, I think that's done. And football comes into play too. You know, I think in the negotiations, you're talking about a football game and a basketball game.
Right. Thank you, Coach.
Mm-hmm.
Next question goes to Mike Kazaza.
Morning, Bob. How are you?
Good, Mike.
Kind of off the beaten path here, but the signing period starts and no news on that. But I don't know that that's actually news, because the way rosters and construction goes nowadays. How different is the approach to that early period, maybe the late period too, but also just in general, signing classes these days?
Mike, I didn't even know what was going on. That's how much attention I pay to it. It's different, man. It's totally different when you look at the guys that are playing for us are sophomores. I mean, and they didn't play very much as freshmen. We got a couple really good freshmen now, but they're not going to play very much. And, you know, when you're bringing in guys who have played in multiple major, you know, leagues and arenas, those guys obviously are more prepared. So we're going to probably try to continue to recruit some freshmen, but it's not going to be the priority that it once was.
Have a follow-up, Mike?
Yeah, I just, is that prohibitive? Is that advantageous for, I have no idea, no opinion on that, but I wonder if maybe you know more about your team or your roster next season, you know, some number of months from now, as opposed to right when the season gets started.
Well, look at the guys we're going to lose. Look at the guys we're going to lose. We're going to probably replace those guys through the portal. That'd be my guess. I mean, obviously you want to get the right guys, but I mean, I think with the guys we have, that this is their last year, and most of those guys are 5-year guys. They're probably going to get replaced by portal guys, not freshmen. Then, you know, because I don't want you writing bad things about me. You know, if I'm playing a bunch of freshmen and we're getting our butts kicked, I just assume you write nice things.
You have my word. Yeah.
Go back to Greg Hunter.
Coach, in terms of Trey Mitchell, how was he the day after having a big run, and anything on Pat Summitt?
He was really good. He practiced the whole practice yesterday, which is the first time he's gone through a full practice. And he was moving well. He was shooting the ball well. I think his understanding of what we expect from him is a lot greater now. He's fine. I mean, I'm a little bit shocked that he's where he is today, honestly.
And Pat, how's Pat coming along?
Much better. Much better. You know, it just seemed that Trey was so much more anxious to get started than Pat was. I think Pat was a little more reserved about it. But then again, you know, Pat didn't go through what Trey went through, you know, and I think Trey really missed it where Pat had played a whole lot more than what Trey did. So I think he was a little more cautious, if that's the right word.
Back to Jerry DePaula.
Thank you. Bob, I'm old enough to remember your games when you played against Duquesne in Pitt at the old Civic Arena. What are some of your best memories of your playing days in Pittsburgh?
Winning. I remember the games we won and not so much the games we lost. We played in the old Fieldhouse a lot. Seemed like a lot. It was fun. It's kind of interesting, the characters that showed up in the old Fieldhouse, but it was, we look forward to it. And we, as a team, I think, look forward to playing there.
Was basketball, more intense back then or more intense now?
Well, you only had two officials then, you know, you could get away with a lot more. You know, you got three officials now, so there's more eyes watching you. I think it was way more physical back then. I think probably because of that. But it was fun, you know, and when it was all said and done, you know, I played on a bunch of, well, we all did. We played in a bunch of money tournaments, and I played with a lot of Pitt guys. Tommy Richards and I were the backcourt in many of those games, but you know, played with a lot of other guys, a lot of Pitt guys, a lot of Duquesne guys.
What do you mean by money games, sir? What do you mean by that?
We got paid to play.
After the season?
After the season.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Of course, we wouldn't do anything
else. I understand that, but that's when it was, after the season?
I mean, I did say Tommy Richards. You know, Tommy wouldn't do anything else. He's a banker, isn't he?
Well, yeah, he was.
No, we had a good time. We had a good time, and they paid us to come and play. It was fun.
Question goes to Mr. Tirada.
Hi, Bob. This is Suichi. I cover the Celtics here in Boston. I just wanted to ask about one of your former players, Joe Mazzulla. Obviously, he's coaching the Celtics now, doing well at it as well. Just wanted to get your thoughts on him and if you were surprised at all that he was able to make it to the NBA this early in his career.
Yes and no. You know, I think he did it probably faster than most. But Joe's going to work at it. You know, Joe's going to work at it. He's going to spend time. He does a great job of absorbing what he needs to absorb, and so, I mean, I was a little bit surprised, I guess, but not totally surprised.
Follow up, sir.
Yeah, and I just was wondering, when he was a player for you, did you kind of maybe realize or notice that he could be a head coach one day? Did he kind of have those attributes?
Yeah, I remember Joe coming over to me saying, "Take me out, I suck." And I said, "Yeah, you're right, you do." But I said, "Just stay out there and see if maybe we can play through this." And he came back over the second time and said, "Will you take me out? I suck." So I said, "Yeah, go ahead, go sit down."
Do you remember what year that was?
No, I don't. But I remember that very vividly.
All right, thank you.
He's the only guy I've ever had say that.
Back to Justin Jackson.
Hey, Coach. One more on Trey. Obviously, if there's any kid on your roster who might understand a little bit of the rivalry, it would be him, coming from the Pittsburgh area. But I'm not familiar with his recruiting background. I mean, I don't know if Pitt really went after him, or I mean, he goes to UMass as a freshman, but you know, with him being a Pittsburgh guy, I'm wondering if there's anything there for him this week.
I don't have any idea. I didn't, you know, we have never talked about it. He is from the Pittsburgh area. He's not from Pittsburgh per se, but he's from the surrounding area. So I'm sure he's well aware of Pitt and their program and their history, but we've never talked about it.
Yeah.
So I don't have an answer for that question.
Yeah.
Oh, Antonik, your hand is up. Do you have a question?
I do. I have two. Quick on Trey. Pleasantly surprised that he performed so well in whatever it was, 14 minutes without practicing. Is that surprise you a little bit?
Yeah, it did. You know, he got the clearance from the medical people. So, you know, that part of it, you know, you still wonder about, you know. And he seemed to be, to me, he seemed to be well, and mm-hmm. he's a smart kid, John. I mean, I think that's the thing. You don't, he was never in a drill. He was never a part of anything. We didn't, I mean, when he had the surgery, he was out. We were not going to in any way jeopardize his career.
Mm-hmm.
So for him to be able to go out and fit in the way he fit in, I think says a lot about his basketball IQ and certainly his intelligence.
Yeah. I mean, you get new guys in there, sometimes they can mess things up, but when he was in there, you guys made runs.
Well, he can make shots.
That helps.
Yeah, well, when you have guys in can make shots, that leads to runs.
Yeah. Last one I have here. I know you've only watched one game of Pitt, but is there a team style-wise you could compare them to that we know, that we've seen?
No, I don't think so. They do a great job of playing the four out stuff, which really opens up, you know, driving lanes and so forth. But they do a lot of other things. And I think I think they're way more versatile defensively than what they were in the past. They're going to play multiple defenses.
Okay.
And they're going to press some.
Okay.
So I think I think they're going to bring a much bigger package than what they brought in the past.
Okay.
Greg Hunter.
Bob, back to your memories of Fitzgerald Fieldhouse and Pitt. Any specific moment, any interaction with Tiger Paul, any of those type of things? You always have great stories.
I really don't want to get into it, Greg, because it may incriminate me.
It's 40 some years. I don't think they can prosecute you.
I don't think that. Well, I don't know. It is Pittsburgh. I don't know, man. There was crazy stuff. I mean, it was when Junior Sample and Tiger Paul got into a wrestling match. I mean, how does it get any better than that? It was a lot of fun. It was a lot of fun. And you know, the neat thing about it was, And there were a lot of scraps and things, and you know, a lot of stuff went on. But the neat thing about it was when it ended, we played. I mean, I played a lot with Pitt guys and Duquesne guys. You know, we played in all those tournaments. I mean, why wouldn't you? You know, if you go make a few dollars and have fun playing ball, why wouldn't you? I went in one time. I was playing for P.I. Drake Castle Club, and he calls me like at the last minute and says, I need you to like get up here. And I was actually was in the dorm. I drive up to Wheeling in that little grade school, whatever it was right there. And so I get in, I walk in the locker room and everybody's in there laughing and having a good time and all that. And I walked in and went dead silent, dead silent. Is it was all Pitt and Duquesne guys. And then P.I. didn't play me in the first quarter. I'm sitting there thinking, what am I doing? You know, I'm thinking if I don't get in the second quarter, I'm going home. He puts me in the second quarter and I played the last three quarters. And Tommy Richards and I end up playing in the backcourt together and in a whole lot of tournaments. The big guys were kind of in and out. They got fired and then they got rehired. And P.I. found a couple of other ones, whatever. But Tommy and I were fixtures in the backcourt. So we played together a lot.
Members of the media, there's no questions in the queue with raised hand. This is our last chance. Any other questions for Coach Huggins?
Hey, Bob, I do have one final one. Incoming recruit, how much can you tell? Is he enrolled yet? When can you start talking about a newcomer?
I can't.
Mm-hmm.
I can't. That it's too early for us to talk about that.